10, Cameron Chambers. And at number 13, Ellis Fullman. Number 15, Jordan Zubuto. And the starting five today, wearing number 5, Jack Lemon. And at number 7, Elias Norman. And at number 8, Zach Atkin. And at number 12, Roman Hotday. And wearing number 23, Nicholas Wang. To this, travelling up and down the country for your chance to win Silverwood. But right here in Manchester is the final stage. Derby take on Islington. Don't forget, tomorrow we have the women's and the men's final. TBC versus Ipswich tomorrow. And the MK Breakers take on Randy Rockets. Into the number 1 basketball sound system up and down the country. You're locked into the sound of the dream team. MC Tar Legend and DJ Wayne.
Welcome back. It's game 4. Junior basketball playing finals. And the Derby Trailblazers take on the Islington Panthers. Sure Shot Junior National Cup final action coming right up.
We've got a big game on our hands. We're looking forward to this one.
This is going to be a big one. A long way with your last game of the day, but I am as always joined by Luke and Kazzy B. Kaz, how's your voice burning up?
It's coping, it's coping. We've had 3 games so far today. And on for the final game of the day, the under 18 Junior Sure Shot National Cup final. It's going to be a good
twister,
one.
Isn't it? Sure Shot. Junior Basketball Cup final.
Someone try and say that 10 times fast.
Yeah, Sure Shot.
But we're going to be in for a good one today. This is the under-18 men's. So Derby Trailblazers and Islington Panthers. Neither team have won the cup before at the under-18 level. The Derby Trailblazers are currently 4-8, sitting in 5th place in the Northern Premier Division. And they came through the cup rounds, beating the Bradford Dragons, the Manchester Magic, Trafford Magic, St. Helens Saints, and then the Reading Rockets Academy in the semi-final. They're averaging 83.8 points per game, holding their opponents to 68.2. And a couple of players you've got to look out for on this squad, Adam. Elias Norman, captain of the team, playing at EABL this season, under 15 Aspire in 2022. And he's spoken about how they've improved throughout each game in the cup run. They're feeling very prepared. It's the most prepared they've ever been. And they're ready to go and take on this Islington Panthers team. Alongside him, look out for Nicholas Wild, also playing in the EABL, 6'9". England under 16 at the Four Nations tournament, GB under 16 training camp. Now watch out for his signature reverse dunk. We're gonna see that in today's game. He does it, he drops it. When he gets hot, he gets going, and he's been with the club since he's just 10 years old.
Wow. Well, as you say that, I just saw him throw a dunk down in the warm-up line there. This guy's something to be feared for definite. But now this is going to be a good game. Under 18 men's, this is, you know, like it is for the girls, you know, this is their final step before essentially moving on to the next phase of basketball, whether that's going to be going to a college in the States or an academy in Europe, or in some cases even turning pro. So, you know, in a lot of ways, you're kind of seeing almost the finished product before the next phase. So, a lot of size out there. We've got a guy at 6'9". You know, we're going to be waiting to see, after seeing another dunk down there again. I'm looking forward to this one.
It's going to be a good one. So if we take a look at the Islington Panthers, 7-1 in the Eastern Premier Division. They are second. Now they've got players from the under 16 team that won the Junior Sure Shot National Cup final back in 2022. Six players from that squad in this under 18 squad, including MVP of that game, Tyrese Poku-Mensah. They came through the cup, beating the Croydon Elite, Wokingham Blackhawks, Cola, London Thunder, and then it was a bye for them in the semi-final as Canterbury Academy forfeited. So they've had a little bit of time between the quarterfinals and this final, and very closely matched up with Derby, averaging 81 points per game, keeping their opponents to 46.7. Now, I mentioned it before, Tyrese Poku-Mensah, the MVP of the Under-16 National Tournament, National Cup, a couple of years ago. He had 32 points in that game, 4 rebounds, 5 assists and 7 steals. Just a really exciting guard to watch. And I don't know about you, Adam, but I'm excited to see him 2 years on.
Well, I remember that game and he was spectacular. The name Tyrese Poku-Mensah. It's one of those. It's like those familiar. You know, when you come to these tournaments, you see these names and they're familiar at under 18s level. He is absolutely on that. Superb player. Completely agree with you. Be incredible to see him 2 years on from that and just see how much his game's developed.
Definitely. Also, someone to watch, Devonte Da Costa. Also played at the under 16 National Cup. He's been playing European Youth Basketball League in the EYBL for Oasis Basketball Academy in London. 14.3 points, 5.5 rebounds and 2.3 assists he's averaging in that. So it's going to be a real battle between these two teams today. So starting for the Derby Trailblazers, it will be Jack Lemon, Elias Norman, Zach Atkins, Rohan Hobday and Nicholas Wilde. And for the Islington Panthers, Tyrese Poku-Mensah, Jaden Dawes, Douglas Owusu, Devonte Da Costa, and Lamar Clark.
Well, Derby are ready to go. They fist bump the table officials. They get on the floor. It's time.
Last game of the day, but still more to come tomorrow with the Senior National Cup Finals.
Nice to see the rest of the team in the house as well. Mr. Hobbs just came and pulled my hood over my head. And of course, Darren Paul is in the house. Always nice to see the commentary family all together. I get to relax tomorrow, watch from the bleachers, Cass, while you lot carry on using your vocal cords, but I very much look forward to it. Bumped into Liv Forster earlier on, had a nice chat with her.
I
said to her, it's weird seeing her, but not under 18. You know, she's old
here.
School now.
Yeah, she's too old.
Yeah, she's an OG now. So, straight away, the first thing you'll see is the height mismatch. Number 23 for Derby, Nick Wilde. 6'9", wins the tip. Islington end up with it, though. Mensah controlling the ball, he's looking for the screen, he gets it, he drives inside, there you go. Doesn't fall for him though, Islington come up with the rebound. Get the ball out and reset, three coming in. There you go. Great start. Jaden Dawes there, hits the big three. That'll settle the nerve of the Islington Panthers. We'll see what Derby can do to respond.
And Dawes, again, one of those players, part of the under-16 squad. When you've been on a stage like this before, you know what to expect. Oh, nice move to the basket as Lemon puts in the reverse. You know what to expect on this stage.
Mensah slows things down. surveys the Derby defence. They decide what they're going to do. They're going to keep it out top for now. Quiet. Good passing here from Islington. The Derby come up with it. Shot comes in but bobbles out. And Islington come up with it. Owusu gets it off to Clark. Shot comes in. Doesn't go. Now, Kaz, Demi Babalola went for 24 rebounds earlier on. Now,
yes,
you're thinking that for Derby, with Nick Wilde at 6 feet nine, he's going to be the one that's possibly going to catch up to Demi.
He could have to be up there.
Yeah. If you look at him now, the way he stood, he's got that big wingspan as well.
That is a wingspan.
That is a wingspan.
It's almost going all the way across the key.
Nice passing movement from the Panthers there. Another three, doesn't go in though. Derby come up with it. Lemon. Loses control, but manages to get it. Goes inside, kicks it out to the wing. Shot doesn't go.
Big rebound
there. Poku Mensah. He starts the ball, goes inside. Oh, there's the first block of the game. Islington somehow managed to keep hold of it, but then turned the ball over and Derby come up with it. Lemon trying to make something happen again. Atkin slows things down. So the score, 2 to the Blazers, 3 to the Panthers, 2 minutes down in the under-18 Sure Shot Cup final. Islington slow things down again and go baseline, comes back out for 3, doesn't go. There's a lot of traffic over in that corner of the court there. It's going to be a Derby ball though. Jack Lemon inbounds. Norman. Mostly guarded by DaCosta. Inside to Wilde. Drops the ball in.
Nicholas Wilde, he's playing in the EABL this season, playing up 3.5 points, we have 4.7 rebounds. England under 16. Started playing at age 5 for the Chilwell Comets and then moved to Derby at the age of 10.
Nice fast break from Derby. Get down the floor quickly. Pop up shot from the elbow, doesn't go. Manages to get his own rebound though. Lemon slows things down. Kicks it out. Nice drive inside off the glass. Norman picks up some contact from, I think it was Devonte DaCosta there. And he'll go to the line to shoot a couple. Makes the first.
Norman talking before the game, he said he thinks it's going to be a very high intensity game from start to finish. I think that's exactly what we're seeing from both of these teams.
Yeah, I'd say so. So double team coming in there. Islington managed to regain control of the ball. Doors hands it off to Clark. Is it outside DaCosta? And it's stripped. Derby come up with it. They get the ball down court quickly in transition. There's a player down in the paint. Three coming in.
Three more.
Doesn't go. Derby working out for the rebound. Good save there at the baseline. Oh, Poku Mensah drove down the floor. Well, I think that the Derby fans were expecting for an offensive foul to be called there, but it wasn't.
The Islington fans very happy with that one in the crowd.
Poku Mensah just kept driving to the hole there. Came up with the basket, and he's going to get the and one.
And that's the pace that he plays with as well. Very, very quick player. He's going to be able to get to the rim. And look at the hustle there, diving in for the loose ball, but it's Darby that come up with it.
Norman controls the ball at the top. Nice passing movement again. Norman cuts it for three. Doesn't go. Rebounded by Islington, who come up with it. Oh, loose ball. Panthers come up with it. And here he goes again. Let's see if he can get in this time. No, doesn't go. That one does, though. Jaden Dawes hits his second three of the night. 8-5, Panthers lead. Midway through the first quarter here at Bellevue. Ball goes inside. And I think, Kaz, that's going to be what they have to do, is try and get the ball inside to Nick Wild.
Yep.
Use his height.
Yep, he can use that long wingspan. Pick the ball out of the air. Put it back in the basket.
Inside defense from Darby here. Shot clock's down to four. Gonna have to get one up. Three goes up. Oh, Poku Mensah says, hey, I'll show you a three-pointer.
Said, I was here 2 years ago and put on a show. I'm gonna do exactly the same today.
Lemon looks for the screen. Norman gets inside. Three coming in from the wing. Goes. Point game, 11-10, Panthers. Well, we thought it was going to be high octane, and it is. Clark. Bounce pass nearly intercepted there. Looking to get it back inside to Mensah. I think the ball came off his foot, though. No, it's going to be an Islington ball. DaCosta will inbound. Dawes is already waiting for it out there. Gets himself into the paint. Mensah. Shot doesn't fall. Darby, no. Around the shot clock, the shot came in there. It's going to be a Darby ball. Shot went inbounds. To Atkin. Wild sets him a screen, he keeps on going. Good passing movement again from Darby. Comes up short on the three-pointer. DaCosta breaks down the court. Hands it off to Clark. Clark wants to go inside, kicks it out. DaCosta gets it back in again. Nice little 1-2. Combination there. Mensah trying to make something happen, but the defense from Derby really intense. 2 seconds on the shot clock, they're gonna have to get one off, and they do. All round the buzzer there.
That's a tough move from Dawes as well, able to stretch over the Derby players, hooks the ball into the hoop.
Jaden Dawes saw that the shot clock was about to expire, and he had to do something. Tough move from him. 13-10 Panthers. Nick Wild, another bucket for him under the basket, puts him on 6 points.
And you see that between Wild and Hobday, the wingspans they have inside just covering practically all of the paint.
Yeah. Atkin controls it, he decides to take the three. Oh, it looked good from this angle. We had the perfect look at it, Kaz, but it didn't go.
And the hustle there from Lemon.
Yeah, he came up with the rebound. Wild wants to go inside, hangs. Is it gonna? No. Well, it seems to take forever to decide if it was gonna go in or not, but I'll tell you what I like. Then Nick Wild showing some hang time on the little fadeaway there. It's It's going to be a Derby inbound from the baseline. Ball goes into Lemon. Three coming in. That was nothing but net.
He's been shooting 66.7% for the Derby College Trailblazers in the EABL this season from three. You've got to watch him.
How many percent?
66.7.
Wow. There's another three, this time for Islington.
Lamar Clark getting in on the action.
Lamar's saying, hey, I'll give you a three. Nice move inside, the kick back out. Good rebound from Islington. Fast break down the floor. Douglas Owusu there ran into three players. And he's going to go to the line to shoot two. It's going to be a Trailblazers ball. Full court comes in.
Offensive foul. Number 5, Jack Lemon.
Well, Lemon picks up the foul there. Islington came in with the full court press. Didn't quite see what the play was, but Owusu certainly put his hands in the air.
Cam Chambers checking in for Derby. It's his first minutes on the court.
Clark manages to get it inside to Dawes. Doesn't go. And just look at how physical Dawes is. He's got that broad upper body strength there. You know, wide at the shoulders, a lot of strength. You know, he's got that kind of Charles Barkley physique, you know. Like, if I want to get to the basket, I'm going to get to the basket. Don't
I'm
worry about
there.
It.
I'm going to grab some rebounds.
Yeah.
Nicholas Wild heading to the bench for Derby. And Joshua D'Ostino checking in.
Dawes makes the first.
Dawes currently leading all scorers with 9 points in the game so far. Make it 10.
It's the second. Well, he had those two big threes at the start of the game. Oh, look at that. Unbelievable move there from Tyrese. Before Derby knew it, he'd already turned the ball over and scored the basket. See how Derby can respond. Norman from the top, doesn't go. Rebounded by Islington. Nice pass to the outlet. There he goes again. Jaden Dawes. This man's on fire, Kaz. He means business.
He's come in with purpose. 12 first quarter points for Jaden Dawes.
There he is trying to pull down rebounds, but Tyrese Pokemensu comes up with it. Another three. Oh! You have got to be kidding. Hey, hey, somebody throw in a fire extinguisher. This man is on fire.
That is a huge bucket at the buzzer to end the first quarter. Jaden Dawes, 15 first quarter points.
Wow. Well, 27-15, the Panthers are up. It's the same in every game, Cass. Somebody comes out firing.
And
in this game,
off.
In this game, Jaden Dawes with 12 points. I apologise, 15 points.
After that buzzer
huge
beating
shot
three.
There with the buzzer beater.
I'm sure we're going to see that back.
Yeah, I want to see that one again for sure.
Right, get ready for our next challenge, chance to win prizes here. It's the free throw challenge.
And that's just swung things for the Panthers in the last minute or two of the quarter. Really evenly matched for most of the way, and then just Jaden Dawes leading the charge as the Panthers come out with a 12-point lead heading into the second. And leading the way for the Derby College Trailblazers, it is Nicholas Wilde with 6 points, and Elias Norman with four.
Well, Islington is currently 5-10 from outside the arc. They're definitely feeling it.
Hey, 50% from three after a quarter, that's a good start.
Yeah, you've got to be happy with that. 17 seconds, yes, two for MP. And of course, we need to make a shout out to Tahir, who's on the court doing the entertainment there. Slowly but surely becoming the voice of British basketball.
Works very hard. You'll see him. There's a lot of the snooker as well.
Yeah. I certainly enjoy hearing his commentary. He does a great job commentating the BBL, and also one of the best hype men you're ever going to see in this business.
Oh, absolutely. His enthusiasm is contagious.
Well, it's a big pressure shot now for this fan who's got to hit the three.
So he was coming back out on court, or trying to.
It feels criminal to give away prizes like that, but we ran out of time, and this is a board game, so we're going to get back to it.
So the final game of today, but the National Cup action isn't over yet, as tomorrow we have the senior men's and senior women's games tipping off at 1 o'clock with Ipswich and Thames Valley Cavaliers in the women's game, and Reading Rockets and Milton Keynes Breakers in the men's game.
So, we are underway, second quarter action. Derby off the ball. Manages to get the ball inside, loses control of it. Islington come up with it. Let's see what they can do on the fast break. Nice drive inside, they lose it. Kofi Mensah gains the ball, calms things down. Calls the play, there's under 10 seconds on the shot clock. And they decide to go inside. Strong move to the basket there. DeCosta makes it count. Oh, great outlet pass. Unfortunate. Chambers couldn't quite keep hold of it there. The pass was pretty good. Okay, Mensu controlling the play for Islington. Waiting for everyone to be exactly where he wants them, but he decides to put up the three while he's waiting. Why not?
That was such a casual three-point shot.
Yeah, I was thinking he was throwing up an alley-oop or something. Good save from Derby at the baseline. Does it go? It will be a blazer ball.
Got a timeout on the floor, and again it's great to see the support in this crowd. Oh my goodness, that's a big drop.
Wow, that's the biggest drum we've seen all day.
I think an orchestra's lost its drum.
Yeah, Derby have brought a drum that needs its own seat.
Islington.
Yeah. I wonder if it had two seats on the minibus. Or it went on the roof rack. That's one heck of a drum.
I wondered where that noise was coming from.
I'm sure that they can hear that drum back down in Islington.
It's massive. But great to see the travelling support for Islington out there. You know, it's a long trip up, and people coming to support their friends, their family, fans of the team, from both clubs here, from Derby, from Islington, bringing their ginormous drums, bringing their
Silla things. There's the drum now. You can see. Look at the size of that bad boy.
Look at this, everyone. That's crazy.
It's got its own seat. Oh, they had to pay twice to get in.
But thank you to everyone that's watching live on the Basketball England YouTube channel. Remember to like and subscribe. You can follow all the action through the social media channels. There's clips, there's highlights, there's interviews. Check out all the goings on from today and get ready for tomorrow's finals.
So back on the floor, Derby have it at the baseline, they will inbound. Shot comes in, but it falls short. And that's going to be a Derby ball again from the baseline, I think. Yep. Atkin to inbound. Did you see the coach shout same again? Bit of a giveaway there.
That's when you need that big drum.
Yeah. Nice movement from Derby. Really good passing movement from Derby. They get it back out top, drive inside. Norman trying to get in all the way. Doesn't quite make it. Islington counter though. Oh, great pass inside. Wow. The pass from Clark in there to DaCosta. The no-look pass. 33-15 Islington. Derby struggling on offense at the moment. Marcel give and go because he get it back. Nice move inside and the floater doesn't go.
And you wonder if we might see Wilde come back out on the floor for Derby, because having him inside, oh.
We've got a player down. I think it's Dawes that's down? Jaden Dawes, number two. Being helped up by his teammates. I'm not sure what happened. He's probably just see if we can see anything on the replay here. Oh, he just kind of slipped. Maybe he hit a wet patch on the floor there, but.
Looks like he's okay.
Yeah. He's kind of lost his foot in a little bit there. He's got like one of his teammates doing his laces up. Maybe he trips on his lace, but. He's going to go back to the bench and just double check it's okay.
We hope he's okay. I hope we can see him back in the game. He had a phenomenal first quarter, 15 points for him. Came out absolutely firing.
So, Poku Mensah. Entering the ball game, Luke Clark. Shot doesn't go, Derby coming with the rebound. Atkin hands it off. Gets it right back. Looking to get something going inside. Derby shot from the outside comes in though, doesn't go. Huge rebound there. DaCosta, his arm was so much higher than everybody else's for that rebound, Kaz.
That's what I was just thinking before. If you put Wild back in the game, so Derby went with him in the game, were keeping it close because his presence inside makes it harder for Islington to get in there.
So Riggs goes inside for the finger roll there. Yeah, you've got to be wondering why Nick Wilde hasn't been brought back into the game just yet. They obviously need his height inside. Shot comes in, doesn't go.
It's that two foul situation again, like we saw in the earlier game.
When do you bring him back exactly? Tyrese to the hole, doesn't go, but he drew some contact. Atkin got a piece of him there.
And you sometimes wonder, is it better to maybe put a player in to try and get into the position where it's closer, or do you wait a bit, trust the rest of your team to pull it back in?
Well, it's a double substitution for Derby there. As they huddle up in mid-court. Mensah takes his first free throw.
Douglas Owusu looked like he was doing his best Bailey Goodall impression there at the side of the huddle.
If you know, you know. So, Ellis Bullard has checked in for Derby. Gets his first touch of the ball. Lennon hands it off. Norman tries to go baseline. Step back. Nice shot from him. Oh, yes. Nice shot from Norman there. Got to do the little step back whether he wanted to or not. Managed to compose himself, keep his balance. Great shot from him there.
offense.
Foul called. I think an offensive foul. And it'll be a Derby ball. 37-18, Panthers. 6:04 left in the half. There's going to be an inbound ball just in front of us here. Derby have the ball in the hand of Chambers. It's out to Lemon. And as we speak, Kaz, number 23 is on deck, looking to check back into the game for Derby. So now is the time. Nice move inside there. Chambers going in hard to the basket, draws the contact.
And I like the call to put Wild back in now. Yes, he's on those two fouls halfway through the second quarter.
Yeah.
But I think the impact he had going. When he was in, yeah, get something going. And really good to see there Jaden Dawes coming back in.
Yeah, big relief for us and the fans that he's back in the game after that unbelievable start he had. 15 points for him so far. Chambers misses the first.
I should have noticed this before. 15 points, shooting 100% from the field, free throw line and three-point range.
Can't ask for more than that. Second one comes up short. Custer gets it out. Here he goes again. Tyrese passes the ball inside. The Custer trips, I think. Trips over the feet of Bullard. Let's see if we can get another look at this. Nice pass inside there. Yeah, he just kind of tripped over the foot of Bullard. It's going to be a foul, though. Devontae Da Costa will head to the line to shoot two.
Da Costa, as I mentioned before, has been playing in the EYBL, the European Youth Basketball League, this season.
Yeah.
Representing Oasis, BA London under-20s in that. You know, that's
some high-level basketball.
Definitely. 14.3 points per game for him in that.
Wild comes up with the rebound. Ball in the hand of Chambers. Chambers with the nice handles there. Gets himself into a bit of a turn there, but gets himself out of it. Lemon wants to go inside. Nice shot in off the glass. Jack Lemon there with the big bucket. Islington back on the attack. Poku Mensa right in front of us. He stops to get everyone where he wants him before he makes his move. He goes inside, kicks it out. I can't quite see, I've got a ref in front of me. Here we go, another three. Doesn't go this time. Da Costa comes up with the rebound. Nice pass inside. Oh, blocked out. Wild. Got a piece of doors there. Lemon over to Norman. Puts up a three, doesn't go. Don't come up with it. Chambers, he tries the three, comes up short. Sam Islington, Panthers do come up with it. Poku Mensa. Nice move inside, doesn't go. Yeah, who else? But Jaden Dawes goes in hard to the basket, gets the foul. Into the free throw line for the and one.
So looking at this score, then, Dawes has 17 points so far in the first half, 18. And our highest scoring game, I think, so far was 25 in the first one.
Yeah, I think you could be right. Lemon. Good pressure defense from Islington there. Wild hands it out to Chambers. Lemon gets it back. Loses control of it. Manages to get it back to Norman out on the wing there. 3 points for Norman. Islington. Tyrese from the top, doesn't go. Goes in for his own rebound though, doesn't come up with it. Lemon comes up with it for Derby. Gets himself in a little bit of trouble with the pressure defence there. Da Costa drops it in. Full court press working well for Islington right now. Lemon with the ball. Lucy right up in his face. Good pressure defence from him. Goes over to help. Islington don't come up with it again. I thought it was going to be their ball. Ellis Bullard working hard there, but doesn't come up with it. Ball back in the hands of Islington. Mensah. Da Costa tries to get the ball back inside. So, thought about the three there, but it didn't go. Nice move inside and the floater. They had to get something off. Good defence from Derby there. Real good pressure defence around the perimeter. Forcing a sloppy shot from Islington. And we have a timeout call. I think by Islington this time.
Yeah, and you see the difference there in the pace of play when Wild's back in.
Yeah.
Makes it difficult inside.
Well, so far, it's all been about Jaden Dawes for the Islington Panthers. He has 17 points, 2 rebounds.
Yep.
But according to the scoreboard, he has 18 points. We're still trying to figure out this balance between live stats and the scoreboard here at Bellevue.
I like to go for the highest.
I do too.
That's,
yeah.
That's going to be my call on it.
Well, whatever it is, he's balling out, that's for sure. And of course, Tyrese Pokemensu having himself a game. 13 points, 4 rebounds, couple of dishes.
And as we've talked about it through the games today, we've seen a lot of these players at under 16 level a couple of years ago, now at this point playing up at the under 18s level. And it's just so great to see the development. And players like Tyrese Pokemensah, we saw him put on a show in that National Cup 2 years ago, 32 points in the under-16s game.
Yeah.
And it's just great to see the development. And again, it's another testament to these programs, to the Islington Panthers programs, all the teams that we've had involved today.
Yeah.
Just the development of the players just keeps continuing to grow.
Well, I mean, ultimately, for me, one of the biggest sort of satisfying things would be in, 5 years' time or something to text you, Kaz, and say, oh, you're watching the GB game. Remember when we commentated that kid at Final Four or the Junior Cup Final? And, I'm convinced that a lot of the guys and girls that we've seen over the past 4 games are going to be at that level at some point.
Definitely. There's a lot of names to remember.
Maybe this guy is the one. He already has the size. But Islington playing some tough defence there.
A whistle on the floor. Ref's just checking something with the table. The Panthers have a 42-23 lead here in the first half, 2:07 to play.
Conversation going on between the referees and the table.
We'd just like to thank everybody watching live on the Basketball England YouTube channel, everyone that's joined us throughout today's game. This is the 4th game today. 2 more to come tomorrow in the Senior National Cup. It's not over. It's going to be 2 great games tomorrow. And a big thank you to all our sponsors, SportServe, SureShot, Dynamic, Wilson and Sport England and Basketball England for putting on such a great show today.
So we're back underway. 2 minutes left in the half. 42-23, Islington lead. Dawes gets the ball back out to Mensu, goes inside. Oh, nice footwork from him. But Nick Wild says, no, I don't think so. Oh, great pass to Wild. There we go. We've been waiting for one whole game, and that was it. But hey, I'll tell you something, Kaz. For me, the pass from Atkin was what made that spectacular.
Yeah,
look at the vision there. Threads the needle. Through to Wild for the big time dunk. Meanwhile, back at the other end, Pokemensu puts up the shot, and I've never seen a ball bounce that high and then go back in.
Showtime on both ends of the floor.
Lemon pulls up, hits it again. Wow.
And Derby getting into a rhythm here.
45-27. Owusu gives it back out to the Costa. Mensa has it. Looks for the screen and gets it. Steps back, the shot wasn't there. Goes inside, DaCosta turns, shoots, doesn't go. Gets his own rebound. No, sorry, he doesn't. Wild comes up with it. Oh, nearly another great pass there. Owusu driving. Oh, he just lost control of it there. Owusu, one of those guys that's so fast, sometimes the ball can't keep up with his feet. And it just goes out of bounds there. So Lemon inbounds, gets the ball back. 23 in the half, 14 on the shot clock, two plays left. Oh, nice give and go there, inside. Atkin makes it count. Two seconds left, pulls up, shoots. Ah, oh, doesn't go. Wow, what a 2 minutes of basketball there was there. For me, highlight play of the half has got to be that pass through there from Atkins to Nick Wild for the dunk. Incredible pass, but hey, the first half has been all about Poku Mensah and Dawes.
It has, and you see the difference that it makes when Wild's back into the game. And Derby going on a nice little run there in the last couple of minutes. It's almost, you're probably thinking they don't want halftime to come because they were just starting to get into a rhythm, find a flow. And it can disrupt that, you know, taking a 10-minute break.
Yeah. Well, we have a scoreline of 45 to the Islington Panthers, 29 to the Derby Blazers. We're going to be right back with you in a couple of minutes. Don't go anywhere. You're not going to want to miss the second half of this one.
Thank you.
welcome back to Bellevue, the National Basketball Performance Centre here in Manchester. It's game four of four here at the Sure Shot Junior National Cup Final. And we have one half left of basketball left between the Islington Panthers and the Derby Trail Blazers. A really entertaining end to the half there. Both teams playing some great basketball. The scoreline is 45 to Panthers, 29 to Blazers. We're in for a very entertaining second half. And as we were talking about the drum game in the first half, now I can see over behind the Blazers bench, this guy has got some sort of contraption attached to him with his drum.
Oh!
Definitely there's definitely some drum wars going on out here today. Now, that's a being an ex-musician, that's a snare drum, Kaz, so the pitch is a bit higher,
right,
a bit louder,
right,
pierces the airwaves more, whereas the immensely big bass drum over there that has its own seat is all bottom-end rumble, so there you go. It's at that point in the day where useless information comes from my mouth at times, hey, but we are back underway.
Everyone needs a drum fact.
Of course they do. Back on the floor, Islington make their charge straight away. I'm sure they wanted to get straight back out on the floor, but Lennon intercepts it. Atkins comes up with it. Nice pass out to Norman for three, doesn't go. Costa lost handle of the rebound, but he gets the ball back eventually from Dawes. The ball back in the hands, Tyrese Pokemensu. Mensu goes inside, gets himself into a little bit of trouble, but gets the shot.
He's going to send him to the line. Hey, you got some appreciation for your drum knowledge in the comments on YouTube. Big Dog Balling, praising that drum knowledge, ads.
Hey, tell you what, the only thing that's missing from this weekend is Big Dog Balling. Big shout out to Nate and Stan, two of the greatest guys in this game. We love you guys and hopefully see you at the next one.
I've been working hard today at the Essex Rebels Women's British Basketball League game against the Manchester Giants.
Indeed. The question is it Nate or Stan that is the person behind the comment?
Oh, yeah. I think they are one. I mean, we know they're two separate people.
They are as one. Big love to Big Dog Balling. Anyway, back there on the floor, Derby have the ball. It's turned over. Mensa comes up with it, drives down the floor, and make it count. This is a man on a mission, Kaz.
He is. What a quick player, what a fast player. You can see the passion he's playing with. He's putting his all into this.
Yeah, he wants this. It's kind of like his last dance this year. Derby just kind of won't go away. Another three there.
When you taste that success at under 16s, you want to bring it through to the under 18s level.
Yeah, you want to be able to say you've got the full collection.
And both teams never having won the cup at the under 18 level. So it's going to be really special for whoever does.
Oh, nice move inside.
Up and under.
Answer with the up and under layup there. Beautiful. Well, here come Derby. They get inside. Nice footwork. Doesn't go. Three ball right in front of us there. Jack Lemon. Hits the big three. ...51-35 Islington lead. Mensa hands it off to the Costa. Lucy wants it out there on the wing. He's still wide open, but he gives it off to Mensa for three. And it goes.
25 points.
Derby come up with it. Atkins. Nice. Threads the ball inside to Lemon. Good passing movement from Derby. Ball back out. Atkins. He goes inside. Tries to kick it out, doesn't go. Uh-oh. He tempted us. He went up like he was going to stuff it and then just did kind of on those in-between layup dunks. I'll take it from Lamar Clark though. Three coming in from Atkins and goes. Well, I'll tell you something, the shooting in this game cast has been superb.
It has indeed. Seven threes for Derby. And seven threes for Islington. So very evenly matched there. Derby shooting 38% from the field, 44% from two. You know, they're good numbers. It's just that Islington are shooting 50% from the field and 52 from two.
I mean, that's some freakish numbers, that, in all seriousness, because those numbers, like you say, that's a really respectable percentage. But to have a team that are out shooting you like that, wow. So it's going to be a baseline ball for Islington. DeCosta gets the ball back from Mensah. He's going to carry the ball down. Gives it back to Mensah. Clark is waiting for it on the wing, and he goes for the travel there. Derby ball.
Oh, great save.
So a bit wild, kind of off guard there. Nice drive inside, doesn't go, but who's there for the rebound? Poku Mensah with the putback. Atkins having himself a good game. It turns the ball over there. Here he goes. Oh, he pins himself. Oh! Well, he got on the breakaway and he went up with all the intention of flushing that thing home and pinned himself to the front of the rim. And sometimes it happens, and he goes down, he knows. But hey, Kaz, I've always been a fan of a spectacular miss dunk. Nothing wrong with that. You got to be in it to win it.
He went for it. And hey, he's got 27 points. The highest score we've seen so far today was 32 in the first game with Athena Thompson dropping that in for the Milton Keynes Breakers.
So I think we can excuse him a missed dunk. But if the photographer under the basket managed to get a picture of that,
hey, I bet it looked good.
Yeah, it looked good.
It did look good. I'm sure we'll see him try another one of them in the game. So a 20-point lead out here for the Panthers. And Islington on a 13-9 run this quarter against Derby. And it was the second quarter. Derby able to keep Islington, so that Islington dropped 27 in the first quarter, 18 in the second to Derby's 14. But we saw Derby go on those runs, and especially with Wild in the game underneath the basket, that wingspan, really problematic, along with Rohan Hobday, both of them on the court together, which they are at the moment. You know, that's difficult to get around, 6'5", 6'9".
Yeah. Well, seems back on the floor. Derby still in this one, 20-point lead. Islington, but still a lot of basketball to play in this one. So DeCosta inbound, Mensah. Nice move inside with the finger roll and it bobbles out. Well, it was a nice move there. Lucky finish though. Oh, great pass inside. Quite connect though.
And Devonte DeCosta has been working hard this game. Sorry, Lamar Clark, number 8, working hard at this game. He's chasing down all the loose balls, trying to get his hand in it, just knocked the ball away.
Absolutely, he's been playing hard all game. Wusu comes up with it, skips down the floor, passes it out. Mensah, another bucket for him.
Do you think he thought, hey, I had 32 last time, let's see if we can break that
maybe,
one.
Maybe. Atkins, closely marked by the Wusu, gets the ball inside. Derby still have it in the paint, they look to kick out. Atkins for three, doesn't go this time, but the rebound from Derby. Oh, nice little turnaround hook shot there. Rohan Hobday. Great rebound and a nice little turnaround shot for him. DeCosta, back out to Clark, hits the three, Well, you know what, Cash, you just mentioned Lamar Clark has been working hard all game there. He deserved that.
Definitely. I like the little spin at the end as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lamar's been one of those players, again, like we say, the JLC type player, putting in that work that you don't see on the stat sheet. And then after the great Joe Leader. From the brain of Adam Masters.
From the brain of Adam Masters, indeed. So, it's an insane. We thought about another three there. DeCosta, Lamar Clark. Has space, puts up the shot. Is it going to? No, it doesn't. Wild comes up with the rebound. Norman goes baseline, turns, shoots. Nice little fadeaway, doesn't go. DeCosta comes up with the rebound. Nice pass inside. Good defense from Norman there. Forces the shot and the buzzer. Well, you know what? The defense from Norman there was great. Forced the shot right at the buzzer, but Mensah's just on fire today. And when they're dropping for you, they drop for you.
There's not a lot you can do against that.
Not really. Oh, nice pass inside. You know what, Kaz? I love this guy's vision with the passes. Atkins, he gets the ball back at the top. Nice screen. Shot comes in. Atkins doesn't go. Oh, nice pass out, though. Lemon. That one goes. Derby refusing to go away.
Yeah, the ball movement from Derby has really, really picked up. They're able to spread it round
the when they pass around like that, it's beautiful to watch. You know, they've got some good shooters out there, and when they're patient like that, they get those looks, and they're scoring some big buckets. But like I say, I really like the court vision of Zach Atkins.
Yeah,
he's made some spectacular passes in this game.
He's been fantastic as well. And it's not always the pass to the basket, is it? It's the pass before the pass, or the hockey assist.
Exactly.
So Islington playing with a relatively short roster rotation here, having just six players that they've gone through, and Derby pulling in three players off their bench. So Islington are really able to use their starters and get out ahead.
So 3:33 left in this one, 65-43, Islington Panthers. Left in this one. Good work from Clark going inside. Still working hard as always. Zach Atkins, close to Mark Bayarusu. I like this little battle these two have had going on. Steps back for three, doesn't go. Wild comes up with the rebound though. Hopday working hard inside. Mensah couldn't quite get to it in time for the save. Wow, with the inbound, Hopday gets it back.
That's a lucky try to save it in, it just rolled out of bounds.
Will be an Islington ball. DeCosta brings it up. Lucy. Go obviously guarded by Povey there, but here come Darby, nice fake. Whoa! Clark is on his own. Is he going to go up for the stuff? No, he's just going to play it safe and go for the layup. Oh, look at the interception there from Mensah.
Takes him to 33.
So he's beating his own record. I think that's a game high for the day as well.
Yeah, that's correct. 32 for Athena Thompson for Milton Keynes in the first game.
Oh, nice spin move. Abde doesn't fall for him, though. Good rebound. Again, doesn't go. Isn't to come up with it. DeCosta. Doors goes inside, draws the contact. He'll go to the line to shoot. points for him.
Got Ellis Bullard checking in for Derby.
Jaden makes the first one. Second one doesn't go. DeCosta nearly got the rebound though. Wild with it. Lemmy. Nice handles from here inside. He has to kick it out. No one there for it though. Here come Islington on the break. Wusu goes to the basket hard. Doesn't fall. Body's flying all over the place under the basket. Islington. Owusu takes a seat. Checking into the ball game. Number 6, Louis Lard for Islington.
It's Joshua Dostino. We had a late number change there.
Atkins goes inside. Ball stripped away.
Heading to the bench for Derby.
Atkins makes his first.
And Elias Norman back in.
Bass drum is in full force. He makes the second, and then his third shot was the foul on a three-pointer. Costa gets the ball back. Just needs to slow things down slightly. Mensah has it. Clark goes inside. Nice little floater there in off the glass. Nice move there. Lamar Clark. Intensity from Islington. Nice drive. Oh, big rebound and then swatted out of there. Went wild with the swat, but the foul had already happened. You see how powerful Poku Mensah is going to the basket.
He's able to get high up in the air as well. As a guard, you know, he is bouncy.
Well, I mean, he's explosive, you know.
Very explosive.
This doesn't go. Second one goes in.
That's 34 points, 7 steals, 5 rebounds and 3 assists for Poku Mensah.
Unbelievable stats for him. Zach Atkins steps back. 3 doesn't go. Islington save it. No, they don't. Jack Lemon's going to inbound from the baseline. Manages just to get the ball up top to Norman, who shoots from the desert. Doesn't go. Does, comes up with it. He knows the play he wants. Mensah goes left, goes right, spins, kicks it back out. Nice drive inside, little floater, doesn't go. Derby come up with it, they had to put up the heave. Well, at the end of the third.
A 29-point lead for the Panthers.
That's exactly what I was trying to calculate, Kaz. Thank you very much.
I do the maths, so you
don't
have to.
Yeah, you do the maths. I left my calculator watch at home today.
So we've just got, it looks like the refs and the table are just discussing something.
I think it's something to do with the shot clock and the game clock.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to put a little bit of time back on the clock, 0.4 seconds.
Well, I actually thought I was going mad because I thought that was the end of the quarter and then it looked like there was still a minute and a bit left. But now we've put 0.4 seconds back on the clock. Islington is still at the bench though.
So with 0.4 seconds, it's a literal catch and shoot or a lob
but,
to the air. Oh,
but Atkins is at the line.
So is he
for two shots. So maybe there was a foul as he put the shot.
But he was shooting a 3, so then it would have been 3. It must have been before the shot.
Well, the referee's signalling that he's got 3 shots. For the second time in the game.
Yeah, so it was a foul. It was a foul on Dawes just as he shot. So, okay. And because it was the long shot, it's a 3-pointer.
Well, he went 3 for 3 last time he shot 3 free throws. Let's hope the commentator's curse doesn't happen and he makes this one too. Well done, Zach. And that'll do it for the third quarter. 75-49, 26-point lead for the Panthers. And I've got to say, Kaz, you know, the scoreline doesn't necessarily reflect how hard Derby have worked. They've played some stunning basketball at times.
Not
but
at all.
When you've got, how can you possibly stop the onslaught of Islington now?
They're shooting 51% from the field and 50% from 3. That's really tough numbers to compete with.
I mean, those are NBA percentages. That's incredible.
And they've been led by Tyrese Poku-Mensah, 34 points for him, along with 7 steals, 6 rebounds and 3 assists. We can see there, Islington, the highest scoring quarter of the game so far, 30 points for them, along with those 27 in the first quarter. And that was the best quarter Derby have had. You know, they were able to score, they were dropping in the threes, and it's just Islington were able to score more and pull away. Yeah. But we've seen some nice runs from Derby.
Well, we have. I mean, I'm just looking at some of the numbers here. I mean, the rebounds, you know, 30 for Derby, 38 for Islington. Fast break points, 13 to 14. Bench points, 15. Turnovers, 15 and 10. But the interesting stat is 3 versus 17 from points from turnovers in favour of Islington. So that's where they're kind of punishing them.
And it says fast break points as well that you get, so 18 from Islington on those compared to 5 for Derby. But this Derby squad as well, we mentioned earlier, they're 5th in Northern Premier Division, joint 5th at 4-8, had a tough start to the season, but they've really, really come through. And there's so many positives that they can take from where they've got to in this season. And, you know, the game's not over yet. We've got another quarter. And it's always such a valuable experience as well. Like Islington head coach William Akufo he's mentioned before, you know, if you lose, you learn to pick yourself up, try again, and it'll eventually result in success, not for yourself, not just for yourself, but for your whole team. You know, he's really proud of the team that have made it here in Islington, and I'm sure you can apply that to all of the teams that have been here today.
We've talked to him at these tournaments before, a real, real passionate guy, great coach, always a pleasure to talk to him. And as it stands, I'll get to chat to him after this game, unless Derby can make a real run for it now.
Hey, let's see what happens. Anything can happen.
It's a game of runs, Kaz.
So, I don't think
Derby.
We mentioned that.
No,
have
we haven't.
No. Tyrese Pocumenta as well, having played the full 30 minutes of the game so far. We'll see what he can do in the fourth with those 34 points. Are we going to get a 40-piece?
Well, maybe, but I mean, we've got two guys that have played every minute. Because as well as him, Devante Da Costa has played all 30 minutes. He's only 2 points off a double-double two. So, some big numbers here from the Islington Panthers. Atkins comes down the floor. Hands it off to Lemon. Finds himself inside. Nice little floater there from Lemon. Makes it count.
Again, I'm loving these signs. We've got more signs.
Yeah.
Go Derby signs in the crowd. I love this, that people have made the effort, brought them in.
Absolutely.
I might make one for tomorrow.
Yeah. Well, now I'll make one.
Go Kaz.
Go Kaz. Keeping Kazzy B on comms. So Lemon manages to find himself inside, kicks it out. Nice pass from him. Norman goes baseline. Kicks it out, Atkins for three. Oh, goes, and he did it with Benson right up in his face there.
That was a tough shot.
Very tough shot. We had the perfect view of it. Benson was all over him. Three doesn't go. Derby come up with it. Lemon waiting for his teammates to catch up with him. Worked hard all game, this man. Atkins, another guy that's worked hard. Partial block there. And Da Costa comes up with it. Clark hands it out to Da Costa. Mensa needs to go inside. Hang shoots, doesn't go. I thought it was going to go, Kaz. But he's on the floor, he landed quite hard. I think he's okay though. Just take a look at that. Nice footwork from him and he floated and he went down. He just think he just, well, visually did the splits as he's landing there.
That puts him at the line. Third foul on Atkins.
This one doesn't go. So, Lemon with the ball. Pressure there from Owosu. Oh, nice pass inside from Lemon. Fade away. Oh, he turned into a fadeaway pass from Zach Atkins there. I think he only realised at the last minute that he was going to have to go for the assist there. And Hobday wasn't expecting it. Da Costa needs to take some time off the clock as he waits. He makes his move. Owosu threads the ball inside. Nice passing from Islington. Lucy gets it back. Wants to spin inside. Ball intercepted by Derby, who come up with it. Norman, he's had a good game. 13 points. Lamar Clark knocks the ball out of his hands right in front of us, though. Nick Wilde will inbound. Bob Day. Looking to get away with the travel there. Body's flying around all over the paint. It's going to be a jump ball. It's going to go the way of Islington as it was their possession. Well, I've really enjoyed this matchup, Kaz, between Mensah and Atkins, though. I mean, every time on defense, Atkins is right there in his face waiting for him while the rest of the team are back in their own half. Clark looking to go inside. Doors, doesn't go. Be an Islington ball. 6:19 left in this one. 75-54 Islington.
Derby having outscored Islington so far this quarter, 5-0.
Oh,
not anymore.
Big three there from Clark.
So if Derby are going to go on a run, they need to,
do it
soon.
Nice move from Hobday, gives it back out to Lemon. Gives it off Atkins for three. Doesn't go, but a big rebound there. Norman keeps it alive for Derby, goes inside, kicks it out. Atkins hands it off again. Wild nearly saved it there. Once again, as all up eight players go back down the floor, Atkins is attached to Poku Mensah like glue.
Yeah, that's been a great matchup all game long.
Yeah, it really has. You know, look at the way they're marking each other now. Not giving each other an inch. I really like these matchups. I'm sure both players got a lot of respect for one another after this game. Wild comes up with it.
And we see, don't we, that these players playing against each other, but when you get through to the international level,
well,
you see them
teammates.
Playing on teams.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's always fun when you have players that don't often get to play together, but do at the national team set up.
Lemon comes down the court with it. He's got help if he wants it, but he goes for the floater, doesn't get it.
I think we've got an injury on the other end of the court.
Bruce run down hard. He's back on his feet. Islington going to make a substitution.
It might be a slippy under the basket.
Yeah. Michael Mahel looking to check in, and yeah, he just loses his footing. I mean, if there's some moisture on the floor, we need some mops. Take a look at that area of the court, because he literally slid over there. Because what you might not realise watching at home is that sometimes when players go down, they all naturally sweat, so the jerseys are wet.
Yep.
So if they lay down on the floor, it leaves moisture on the floor. And then if it's not mopped up, someone can slip in it. It looks like that's just what happened. So, Islington, 78-54 up. DeCosta. Ball swung out to Clark, gets the ball inside to Dawes, hangs, doesn't go. And he'll go to the line.
Drum wars still going strong in the crowd. So thank you to everybody joining us on the Basketball England YouTube channel. Make sure to like and subscribe. Follow Basketball England on social media. Keep up to date with all the scores from today's games, clips, highlights, interviews, and they'll be bringing you more of the same tomorrow.
Tough move inside, stripped away. Chambers is back in the game. Wild loses it. Tobias Norman was there for it though. Nice moving on the blast from him. Mahal is in the game for Islington. Chambers comes up with it. Nice pass from him. Good layup. Well, there's a timeout call, but that was a great layup there from Norman. Straighten off the dribble, kept his composure.
Yeah, Norman's been big for Derby today. 17 points for him, along with a couple of assists. Knocking down four threes. Leading the way in scoring for Derby. It is Zach Atkins, 17 points for him, along with three assists and two steals and three blocks.
Well, I've been really impressed with Zach Atkins. I think he's played a really good game. I mean, who wants to, you know, play, defend Tyrese Pokemensa? And he's, you know, how can you stop a guy like that? But what he has done is he's persevered. He's not backed down from the challenge. Every time on defense, he's straight on him. Yeah?
Yeah.
So when a guy's getting hot like Mensa's been doing, he's done really well against him. And he's come up with some big shots. He's hit his free throws. And a huge performance from Zach Atkins. I really enjoyed watching that matchup today. I think he's done a really good job. It always hurts when you're that many points behind, but he's done a good job.
Yeah, and one thing I think that sticks out about Zach as well, he's another player playing in the EABL for Derby, played with the Nottingham Hoods at the under-18 and under-14 level. And, you know, it's a few years ago now, but he was named the coach's under-14 player of the year back in 2017-18. I think that shows when you have a coach's player of the year, it shows
what a team player you are. Yeah. I mean, I'm just watching him off the ball. He's not even looking at what's going on behind him right now. All he's looking at is Mensa, trying to contain him, keep him away from hitting that 40. And a nice pass inside from the man we're talking about. There's Linton taking their time, taking time off the clock. Passing the ball around the perimeter. Clark. Shot doesn't go. Derby come up with it. Chambers. Here we go. He's going to give us a highlight. Yes, he is. Stuffs it down. He does it for his fans. Big flush there from Nick Wild. Islington once again slowing things down. Atkins managing to, as we just look at the dunk there. Great shot, look at that. And back on the floor, it will be a Derby ball. Atkins, he's going to go one-on-one with Mensa again. Still not giving in. Good passing. Three. Bobbles out. Good rebound. Wild doesn't go. This man's worked hard as well. He can save that bucket. Rowan Hobday's worked hard, Kaz. Deserved the bucket there and he got it.
He certainly has.
Hobday pulls down the rebound. Norman gets it out to Atkins. Norman gets it back, goes inside, kicks it out, Chambers for three, doesn't go. Derby come up with it, Atkins for three, doesn't go. DaCosta with the rebound, he controls it, it's a new player on the floor for Islington. Luca Clark sees his first action of the game. DaCosta with it, Mensa. Double team coming in. finds himself inside. Wild comes up with it. Chambers gets the ball back, drives inside. Oh, great move. Great move. Minute 30 left in this one. Again, Islington trying to take some valuable seconds off the clock. Mensah and Atkins once again one-on-one. Kicks the ball out. Good defence from Derby. They do manage to get the ball inside and they force the turnover. Well, for Derby to force a shot clock violation when they're that many points behind with a minute to go. Well, I say that many, they've managed to pull it back. Back to 12 points. Atkins is going to make one last run at this game. Swings the ball out to Norman. Gets the ball back. Nice pass inside. Habde can't control it though. Mensah comes up with it. Mensah once again slows it down. They just want to get seconds off the clock. Clark holds it. Ball goes around the perimeter. Goes inside. Reverse lay in.
It's a great finish around the basket.
Good finish. Hopday puts two back on the board. 12-point game. 30 seconds to go in this one. Islington just want this to finish now. Trying to take some more seconds off. There's definitely two plays left though. There's 14 on the shot clock, 18 on the game clock. Well, puts the shot up, doesn't go, and that's going to do it. The Islington Panthers win this one, 80-68 now. Derby did well to bring that back to within 12 points at the end of the game. And you know what? All props goes to the Derby. Blazers for what they did in that game. They played hard defense. The matchup between Zach Atkins and Poker Mensah was awesome throughout the game. Both teams played well. Unfortunately, there always has to be a winner though, but Islington, you were spectacular today. Some huge numbers coming in from them. Poker Mensah, 34 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists. Dawes, 19 points and 6 rebounds. DeCosta, 10 points, he has a double-double, 15 rebounds and 5 assists. Clark, 17 points. Some big performances there from Islington, Kaz.
Huge, and 7 steals as well from Poku Mensah. That was so crucial as well. Able to grab the ball and then finish at the other end. He's going all the way. He's been working hard all game long. Huge performances from everyone out on the court for Islington. And for Derby, Elias Norman, 19 points for him with 3 assists. And Jack Lemon, 14 points, 7 rebounds, 5 assists for him. And Nicholas Wild, 10 points, 6 rebounds, 4 blocks. So a well-deserved win for the Islington Panthers. Congratulations to them. They worked hard all game. And as I said, we saw 6 of these players at the under-16 level 2 years ago. They won. They won then, and they've come back. We're now behind the leadership of Tyrese Poku Mensah again, MVP 2 years ago. Is he going to be MVP today? MVP today, we're losing our words. Let's find out very shortly. He played the full 40 minutes, just a hard working.
Yeah, I mean, there was him and also Devonte DeCosta played the full 40 minutes as well. But then if you look at Dawes and Clark, they played 37 minutes as well. A lot of basketball played by them today.
Definitely see there, Wild dunks. As he puts them down. Yeah. And again, Adam, it's just such a great display, isn't it, of the talent that we've got in this
well,
country.
Well, it really is. I mean, you know, we've seen some great performances all day today. We've seen some great matchups, and we wanted this last game to go out on a bang, and it certainly did. I thoroughly enjoyed it. It's So all that's left for today is the business of presenting the trophies and medals and to see who the MVP will be. Now, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that Tyrese Pokemensu, with 34 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists, and an index of 38, has got to be the contender for this one. And he's been the high scorer of the 4 games today.
He certainly has, and Jagan does as well, putting in a shift. He had 15 points in the first quarter, finishing with 19, 6 rebounds, 2 steals, and 2 assists. He dropped in 3 threes. The shooting from Islington was just fantastic. 46% from the field, 47% from 2, and 42% from 3. And for Derby, 37% from the field, 27% from 3. It's just those fast break points. Derby catching up there in the fourth quarter, as Islington finished with 18, Derby catching up with 15.
Yeah, I mean, those guys did a great job to get it to within 12 points, as we said. They worked hard all game, they did a great job.
So we're going to get the presentations, the MVP award, and then we'll grab an interview. The winning coach and MVP. And Adam will bring you that from courtside. So coming up to collect their runners-up medals is the Derby College Trailblazers. After a hard fought game today, led by head coach Jeff Hobday and Rowan Varley, assistant. Derby can be proud of their performance today as they make the trip back home, and I'm sure we'll be seeing a lot of these young players again very shortly. Medals, it is the Islington Panthers. With head coach William Akufo. Team coming up on court, as we mentioned earlier, 6 players in this squad that played at the Under 16 National Cup back in 2022. They had a big win over the Richmond Knights. They've come back at the under-18s level. And they are the winners of the Junior Sure Shot Under-18s National Cup. Announced, and it is Tyrese Pokumensa. An incredible game from him. 34 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists, and 7 steals. A well-deserved MVP. We saw him doing it at the under 16 level. He's back. He's done it again at the under 18s.
The only losing walking in the meeting is about to collect the trophy too.
So the trophy will be collected by team captain. It is Tyrese, has to hand his MVP ball over. He goes to pick it up. So your under 18 men's Sure Shot National Cup winners are the Islington Panthers. Congratulations to them, an 80-68 win over the Derby College Trailblazers. An interview with head coach and MVP head coach William Akufo and MVP Tyrese Pokumensah. So Adam will be speaking with MVP Tyrese Pokumensah. We're going to go courtside. Over to you, Adam.
Well, Tyrese, big time players come out in big time events. This was one of them for you.
Yeah.
Unbelievable start line, 34-6-3, 38 index. Now, we was wondering whether you had it in the back of your mind that you were the MVP under 16s and you were going to go for the double today. You have done.
Yeah. Not really. I just wanted to play as a team. I don't really focus much on the MVP. Yeah.
So, all about the individual performance, but I tell you what, you guys really came well together though. There's other guys with big numbers, you know what I mean? You look down the list and you're sort of thinking, well, DaCosta, Clark, yeah. Does all came up big.
Yeah.
What's the real family feel to this club? Is that what it's all about? Family
yeah.
first?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All of us have been playing since under 14s.
Yeah.
So
you've all come through all the ranks to get to this point now.
Yeah.
So this must be really satisfying, you coming out of 18s, going into your next phase of your career,
yeah.
to go out on a high like that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So you got a plan for next year?
Not a sure plan, but hopefully.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, congratulations,
yeah.
MVP. Incredible performance. That guy, Zach, kept you busy all game as well, didn't
yeah.
he? Yeah, he's a good player.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, congratulations, yeah. man.
And before we end this interview,
yeah.
I want to commemorate this game to Jonah. He recently passed away, and we played well for him. We played hard out here for him. Can you say that?
Nice words. Appreciate yeah. you, man. Nice sure. one.
That was Adam with MVP Tyrese Pokumensah. Well-deserved MVP for him. A really exciting player to keep an eye on. And at the end of a fantastic day of basketball, a fantastic day of youth talent on display. The final game of the day, the Islington Panthers 80, the Derby College Trailblazers 68. Thank you so much to everybody who has joined us today on the Basketball England YouTube channel. We've had four fantastic games and it doesn't stop there. Tomorrow we will see the senior finals between Ipswich and the Thames Valley Cavaliers in the women's game at 1 o'clock, and then the Reading Rockets and Milton Keynes Breakers in the men's game following on from that. So be sure to come down, check out the action in person at the National Basketball Performance Centre here in Manchester. And if you can't make it down, you can catch all the action on the Basketball England YouTube channel on the live stream. So thank you to our sponsors, Sure Shot, Wilson, SportServe, Sport England, one more, Dynamic, and Basketball England for putting on such a great show.
We're off to buy some throat lozenges.
We are indeed. Thank you to everybody who's joined us, and make sure to tune in tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah,